How do you go above and beyond to show someone just how much they've meant to the world?
Kyle Carpenter. On August of 2010 in Helmand Province, Afghanistan, was a detachment of 12 Marines on Operation Enduring Freedom. An insurgent throws a hand grenade, and Kyle, without hesitation, jumped on the hand grenade to protect Corporal Euphrasio. I would go to employees and ask them if they'd like to donate tour fund to fly the Carpenter family here, and we're going to pay for everything. That hero of mine spent 3 years at Walter Reed. They told him he'd never walk, and he would never be able to do anything else in life. He's a fighter. He's a hero.
Well, no problem. How are you doing? It's my pleasure to let you know that I've approved the award of the Medal of Honor for your courageous actions in Afghanistan.
As far as, you know, actually getting the medal, it's just very surreal. But at the same time, it's not really mine. It's the Marine Corps. It's the nations. It's our entire militaries. And those that, you know, were injured on the battlefield, and those that didn't even make it home to get a pat on the back, much less a Medal of Honor.
It was a very emotional event. It makes me so proud to honor a gentleman like him, United States Marine.
Commander Colton, the moment we got off the plane, we were just shown so much love and support. You don't find that in everyone. He just truly, truly cares and wants to see a smile on your face, and that's enough for him as payment.
The highlight of this whole trip was the day he was leaving in the driveway, I put him in the limousine. Kyle gets out and says, "Come here, Commander." He called me Commander Colton. I saved the best for last. He gave me a hug. We cried. And at that point, he coined me the Congressional Medal of Honor coin with his name on it from Afghanistan.